Let's talk sugar on soybeans. One of the most questioned topics this past year has been, should I be using foliar-applied sugar on my soybeans? Sugar has been around for several years. Starting in 2009, we ran a sugar foliar study on soybeans in collaboration with local growers. There's a sugar bee plant up the road that makes white table sugar for use in common dining. It seemed very practical and cost effective to use. The first year we saw a great increase in yield and ROI. The second year was about a break even. And the third year, a near 5 bushel loss. In these trials, we learned that white table sugar molecules are too large to enter the plant through the stomata. And if not dissolved correctly, they acted like tiny magnifying glasses, causing little burn holes on the leaves. Using white table sugar on soybeans was a good theory that turned into a negative ROI. What reopened our interest in foliar-applied sugar was the increasing industry focus on producing products with a sugar molecule as the base structure while eliminating handling and mixing issues, as well as increasing the mobility into and within the plant. In 2017, we tested 3 products, Exceed Nano Brown Sugar from Max Systems, Carbose from Genesis Ag, and a standard feed grade dextrose. 3 different products, 3 different sizes, but all designed for foliar application. In our study, each of these 3 products were applied foliar at R1. To note, we are using a soybean price of $9.79 per bushel and the most recent 2018 product prices to calculate the ROI in these studies. All 3 products showed a positive return on investment. The standard feed grade dextrose showed the lowest ROI with a 0.8 bushel per acre increase and a positive $5.50 ROI. Carbose delivered a 0.7 bushel per acre increase and a positive $5.57 ROI. And the top performing product was Exceed Nano Brown Sugar. This product increased yields by 1.1 bushel per acre and delivered a $8.93 ROI. Next, we wanted to find out when the best time is to apply sugar to get the maximum benefit. In 2016, we saw a good return on investment, around $30 per acre, when we sprayed Exceed Nano Brown Sugar on soybeans at the R3 growth stage. So in 2017, we expanded the study to compare the effectiveness of applying 8 ounces of Exceed Nano Brown Sugar at the V3, R1, R3, and R5 growth stages. We found that the R3 growth stage showed the best results, increasing yields by 4.3 bushel per acre, which delivered a positive $40.32 ROI. Let's gain a better understanding of why spraying sugar on soybeans can help increase yields. I look at sugar on soybeans in 2 ways. 1, sugar is a boost of energy. Think of it as a little energy shot for the microbes. And 2, sugar helps in the process of building sugar within that plant. At the R3 stage, we see the most amount of pods being formed. That plant is transitioning from building sugars and storing them to building sugars and translocating them into grain, which ultimately we harvest. This is the reason we see the best ROI when sugar is applied at the R3 growth stage. Should you use sugar on soybeans? AgRevival says yes. The optimal time to apply is at the R3 growth stage. But for the grower who isn't willing or able to make a separate pass to apply sugar, an application at R1 growth stage mixed with your other chemistries has also shown a positive return on investment. And it's important to remember when choosing your sugar source that the size of the molecule is crucial. Large molecules, such as those found in table sugar, have shown a consistent negative ROI. To see the complete list of products tested and the results, visit agrivival.com. And if you have questions, leave us a comment or email me at nateferley@agrivival.com. Are you currently applying sugar on your soybeans? If so, which products do you use?